The plant pictured here is Fragaria ananassa, the common strawberry. Strawberry is a low-growing herbaceous perennial that only gets about 4 to 7 inches tall, and it produces runners or stolons that spread laterally and form new plantlets. The leaves of strawberry are pubescent, especially on the petiole as shown here, and they are trifoliate leaves or ternately compound leaves. Here you can see a single ternately compound leaf. The leaflets are ovate to orbicular in shape, and they have large dentate teeth on the margins. In addition, if you look at the lateral veins coming off of the midvein, they're all distinctly parallel to each other. You don't often think of strawberry as having a fall foliage color, but it can be quite attractive in the fall with red, orange, and yellow fall foliage color as shown here. The flowers of strawberry are pink, but they may also be white or a dark reddish pink. They are perfect flowers with multiple stamens and pistils in each flower. Here you can see the fruit. Strawberries are not true berries, instead they're what's known as a false fruit. The receptacle tissue actually swells surrounding the achenes, which we think of as the seeds of the strawberry, and that's what we eat, is this false fruit that is mostly receptacle tissue. The fruits are green when they first begin to form, and when ripe, they turn the red color that we're all familiar with. You can see that the fruits of strawberry are on quite long pedicels, several inches long. NC State also has a strawberry breeding program, and while it has not released as many strawberry cultivars as it has blueberry cultivars, there are still quite a few, which can again be seen on the link on the vaccinium page. Galetta and Bish are two of the most recent cultivars released by NC State, and these two cultivars were both bred for characteristics such as disease resistance, large fruit, and fruit with good flavor and attractive appearance. So with that, we conclude our discussion of Fragaria ananassa, the common strawberry.